Hello viewers, and welcome back to Renowned Explorers International Society. Last time we fought, probably Dracula. We beat him to a pulp, and we stole all his stuff. Bit of a theme. This time, we're going to desperately try to acquire another 1,000 victory points here, another 1,000 renown. I think we can do it, but that's because I know some stuff ahead of time. I stopped recording last time before I made all of the decisions that we had to make, and so you didn't see that I chose to open up another entourage shop, Copacabana, in Rio de Janeiro. Before we consider that, let's consider our final bout of research papers. So we would really like to finish the engineering tree, but I think that there's basically no chance of that happening. That said, yeah, if we could get plus 100% renown from gold, that would be really great. We have 5 renown. Or 5 insight, rather. That we could spend on... Maybe we could do it. Let's take effective equipment. At this point, increasing the payouts of our tokens is only good for renown, but, you know, renown is the thing we want, so let's go ahead and take that. 100 research. Let's go for a treasure hunt token every time we find a treasure. Now let's go for hyperspeed airship. This will help us prepare. We need to get to 120 research if we want to complete the tree and get the extra renown bonus from gold. I would really love to do that. So, let's see. We have 5 insight. Let's see if we can make... Actually, let's have a look at this. Maybe we can get the new one. Maybe we can get a specialist that will increase the payout of our science tokens. We had something like that last time. Let's just upgrade this all the way right now. Indeed, plus 6 research from study tokens. Wow, these are also really powerful though, jeez. What else do we have access to? Bonuses for succeeding on the adventure wheel. Man. The music has gotten really excited. Listen to that whistle. That guy's really going for it. Fantastic. Okay, let's... Hold on. Plus 6 research from study is a huge amount. If we were to spend our tokens like this, we would get 3 research on average plus 10. So 13... 5 times is not nearly enough. If we added another 12 times 5 research to that, we'd be close, but not quite there. And we don't get any extra... There's no way for us to get more... Yeah, this is the way that gets us the most science. Cape Town. Alright. Let's hire that guy. Even though it doesn't get us nearly as much renown in the overall. Because if we can make it to completing that research paper, I think that's going to be the greatest renown boost. It would cost 800 status to buy the rest of these guys, but I think we have to buy some scientists. We'll be close. I think the expected value of spending all of our tokens in Cape Town right now, all of our insight in Cape Town right now, is 110 science. So, if we go hard on scientists, or the students here, this has an average value of 13. So it would be 26 plus, okay, so 29 times 5 is sufficient. I think we should be good now, as long as I did my math right. Yeah, 29. Yeah, this should do it. Okay. 25 is a pretty bad roll. It's not going to matter. We're totally getting there. Okay, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Yeah, I'm really happy about that. Okay, I think we're going to be able to make it. We got all the way up to 1600 just from doing that. So we have 640. That's enough to... Oh, we're 10 status short of being able to hire one of these guys and one of the guys from Copacabana. That's a real shame. I don't think there's anything we can do right now to get an extra 10. Probably we would have been fine with one less student, and that would have let us hire one of these guys and the last guy. Yeah. We miss math somewhere. When I say we miss math, I mean I miss math somewhere because I'm going too fast. Trying not to spend the entire video doing math. I mean, as exciting as that is for you guys. So, collect tokens now have our best renown payout because we get double renown from them. I believe that's correct. Yeah, it has to be right. So we want somebody who gives us extra collect tokens. This guy gives us extra collect from level 3 or 6 rogues. We're already a level 3 rogue. And we're not going to get to level 6, I don't think. So let's hire him. And instead of learning a perk from him, because a fourth point of rogue doesn't really benefit us, we'll put him to work, which gives us a treasure hunt token. Which should be... Yep. That's some renown right there. Not as much as I was hoping for, I'm not going to lie. But the treasure hunt token had status on it, and it got us to enough status so we can hire the other guy. That was a nice thing to oops into, but really, I should have been paying attention. He's already a level 2 athlete. We can't get to the next level of athletiness. So we'll take this. Pepe the Destroyer. Hold on a second. This guy's name is Pepe the Destroyer. Let's not gloss over that. This would be 25, 30 gold, or 30 research. I think this does more for us than a third point of athlete. Again, just in terms of renown. But also, it's left us with quite a lot of money. And by taking Hyperspeed Airship, we did unlock the other two item shops that we chose not to unlock earlier. But I'm not sure that we want to spend gold upgrading them, honestly. These are not mind-blowing right off the bat. And we could just upgrade this to its maximum. And then buy some really, really powerful items. Like buy a couple of 700 gold items. We can also afford one legendary item, but I don't think we're going to get quite as much bang for our buck on that. Honestly, our offensive stats are even pretty good. We may just want to buy new armor. Right, our defensive stats are starting to look pretty bad. So I think we want to upgrade hers. Oh, that's right, we have these. We should give these to Pedrino because being excited will be way better for him than it is for everybody else. So let's buy the second best level of Memento for her. That'll get her defenses nice and high. Who's got the next weakest? Pedrino's defenses aren't great, but he has a ton of grit. Oh, we're not even going to be close to the 700 that we need to... If we sell these, we will be. That's probably worth doing. So let's sell those and get him some adventure armor. And Pedrino, you're just going to have to skate by on charm, buddy. I believe in him. I think he can do it. So, 14 supplies, 8 resolve, 1629 renown. Let's get a move on. There is only one 5-star expedition. It is Shangri-La. There's a lot of renown to be had, but it's also significantly more difficult than all the other expeditions. I do believe Shangri-La is our only chance of getting over 2500, so we have to do it. An incredibly perilous expedition. Rivalu has obtained the Shambhala Key of Privilege to open the gate to Shangri-La. If you're fast, you can collect more Shambhala Keys and get there before he does. You'll find the toughest challenges of all sorts and kinds. Sorts and kinds, all of them. But there's an amazing amount of renown to be gained. Well, that's us. That's what we're doing. This is it. You can finally prove that you are a better explorer than Rivalu. You can do so in none other than a most magical place, Shangri-La, the Himalayan Utopia. The background music kind of sounds like the Zeal track from Chrono Trigger. I like it. It is said that one's dreams come true bit by bit when you are in Shangri-La. Well, our dream is to beat that punk-ass Rivalu, so hopefully this is... At the center of Shangri-La is the Palace of the Sintamani. This orb is a treasure of mystic proportion, on par with the Ark of the Covenant and El Dorado. If you retrieve it, you will go down in history as one of the greatest explorers of all time. Can you see Bia among the illustrious row of Vasco da Gama, Zheng He, and Ibn Battuta? I hope I said that right, Ibn? Yeah, that'd be a dream come true, man. But first, you need to beat Rivalu. It is said that the orb can only be obtained with the 4 Shambhala keys. Those will surely give you an advantage at the palace. As you know, Rivalu has one, and he'll be looking for the keys as well, so it's better to find them before he does. However, you might be able to snatch the orb away from him even without the keys. That sounds like something we would do. Pedrino's really excited about this adventure, and Philippe is so mad at him. What happened on the airship on the way here to cause this expression? Whatever, it's time for adventure. Wow, look at how incredibly high the costs are for exploring this area. So this is the final battle. Each one of these is a place where there's a Shambhala key, and we really do want to get as many of them as we can. So it would be 2 supplies to move up to here. And then 2 to move over, 2 to move back down to here. Or 3 to go here direct. Or 3 to go here by way of this node. Philippe is max level. Pedrino and Bia both are pretty far off. Pedrino's so far off that it's not even worth worrying about. But Bia potentially could get there. Alright, we're going to take the encounter because we really want to try to get her to max level. Some demons are guarding a mountain pass. You could engage them, or you could take a longer route. That would cost us a lot of supplies. We're going to show our worth. We're going to mess these demons up, man. Okay. So, we have 2 red demons, a blue demon, and a green demon. The red demons are aggressive. Wow. These guys have a lot of resistances and weaknesses. We're going to have to be very careful about how we approach this. So if we go friendly, we'll get some speech defense from the mood imbalance. This guy is weak against impressed. She has 45 speech defense, so it might be reasonable to have her just stand here, hold the bottleneck, and throw it. Wow. He's weak against that, and it does that little damage. Hold on, let's have a look at his stats again. 50 speech defense, 20 armor. He's resistant to enrage. I'm wondering if it may be better to enrage him and just go to town on his face. If we start devious, we can attack once without having to worry about it pushing us over into aggressive. If we start friendly on him by using Bia's impress, then the first time we attack, we will take over. Alright, so here's the plan. Pedrino runs around this side, tries to get this dude with the enrage. This would be ideal. Okay, that's great. Now, we'll hit him with the double attack, because we just improved Philippe's attack to have two strikes. Alright, that's something. And now, she can down him with try to impress. Alright. He's confused. We did a lot of different things to him there in quick succession. All he knows is that he just doesn't have the will to fight anymore. Sadden is certainly better than Terrify for us. The game heard me. I should keep that shit under my hat. Alright, this guy's weak to enrage. Why does he have... He has a buff, it looks like. Well, they all actually do. Weird. Might be a little bit of a graphical error. Alright. Get enraged. They don't like this. And then... Bia has a much higher attack stat. Yeah, it's going to be... Bia's going to come over here, and she's going to lay on the double strike. Unfortunately, this is going to put us into aggressive, which lowers our speech defense. We're just going to have to hope that they decide that they also would like to be aggressive. Do we need to do Tranquility for the sake of Philippe's survival? Yeah, we might have to. It's a little bit of a shame to use it when only one person's injured, but I don't want him to die. If we keep them bottlenecked like this, at least they can't gang up on him. Yeah, without the Tranquility, I think he would have gone down there. Alright. Weak against Excited and Confident. His Confident attack only has a one tile range, so we can't really use it here. We're going to back him up. Drop the Amnesia Dart. Have Bia move in. Wow. This unit's speech is increased when you are aggressive. He has so much armor. Why does he have so much armor? What does he need all that armor for? We're just going to try to fight through it. Bia's attack value is so much higher than her speech value. It's actually not higher enough. Alright. Get our Terrify on. Take advantage of his very low speech defense. We should only see... Oh! Wonderful. That's excellent. Should only see one attack from them. Yeah, but he's just running around idle. I wish we had any chance of getting Tranquility off again. Alright. If we do it like this, at least, we'll have... this should buy us some time. Alright, he can't attack... I don't know if that means that he will use a speech or he just won't do anything. I don't actually know whether he has speech attacks. Looks like he does. Oh no, yes, I knew that. We saw them doing that earlier. So now, while he's enraged, we can do this. Bia does have her double strike off cooldown. Alright, get in there and finish him. Oh, it looks like a single strike is actually all it takes. Okay, we managed to defeat those demons, and we didn't lose any resolve in the process. I'm pretty happy about that. Those demons can be a tough fight sometimes. We're doing well, getting lots and lots of tokens. You broke the demon's will and continue through the pass. The demons even gift you gold in tribute, as well as telling you how to sneak past demons. Hey, that is handy. Alright, then we do this. Try to get some supplies back. You find a simply beautiful monastery. It looks like a place where you could get a good rest. A friendly monk is sitting on a porch. Well, let's talk to him. The friendly monk bids you welcome. Traveler, if you're exhausted, you can rest in my garden. However, taking shelter here will lower your renown. Choose wisely. So our renown from tokens will go down by 15%. But we'll get 3 supplies and a resolve. Can we just talk to him? Could be most pleasant and insightful. Oh wow, except that we are idiots. No speakers, very little diplomacy. On second thought, minus 1 resolve. Actually, minus 1 resolve might be a small price to pay for the potential windfall. I am not going to use our tool on this. I'm going to save our tool for trying to get the Shambhala keys. Because that can be difficult, and the Shambhala keys are too valuable in the final battle, if you can get them. We're going to gamble the resolve, because the payout if we win is so very high. Can't say we didn't expect it. All those metaphors and vague wisdoms just confuse Philippe. Humiliated by ignorance, Philippe mopes off. Renown from tokens is decreased. It doesn't affect our renown from treasure, though, and that really is going to be the vast majority of what we get. So I think we're going to do this, just try to let the supplies and the resolve carry us into getting as many treasures as possible. There's quite a few available here. You stay for the night and sleep like a baby. The whole crew wakes up the next morning refreshed. You enjoy a free breakfast supplies, too. This could be a great tourist destination if it weren't for all the dangers around. The man bids you good morning. I wish you good fortune on your travels, explorer. Okay. Well, this is the most direct way to the first Shambhala key. The crew arrives at a small forsaken monastery with the exact same background as the last location. The gate leading to the court looks inviting. Well, let's take a look. Inside you find a weird sight, an inscribed gong, a well-kept courtyard, and an incredibly focused monk who totally ignores you. Let's investigate the courtyard. Bia can't help but be impressed by this amazingly well-kept piece of architecture. So we could get study and discovery tokens or secret and campaign tokens. A discovery gives gold. It's like 25 to 30 research and 25 to 30 gold. And we do get more renown from gold than from other tokens. Quite a lot, in fact. Or from gold than from the other resources. But you get less research from study tokens and discovery tokens than you do status from secrets and campaigns. And I'm wondering if the sheer difference in the amount of resources is gonna... hard to say, and I'm not gonna try to do the exact math. That would slow the video down too much. We're gonna take this one because it gives gold, and the other ones don't, and the other choice didn't. Let's strike the gong! It echoes through the valleys. You're not sure if anything happened. That's true, I'm really not. Is this monk going to be any easier to talk to than the last one? No. The focused man seems to be in a deep trance. The prophecy. Mount Kailash. Maybe you can get him out of his zone diplomatically. You know what? This math was good enough last time, it's good enough this time. Look at all of the payout if we win. Totally worth the chance of losing a resolve. We lost the resolve. That's fine. The man keeps on humming, much to everyone's frustration. You won't get anything out of this geezer. He doesn't really look that old. I don't know if we should call him a geezer. Alright, well, let's leave. With nothing of interest left, the crew leaves the monastery and continues exploring. That's true, I do continue exploring. 2 supplies to get here. Alright, let's try to get a Shambhala key. You arrive at a place where one of the Shambhala keys is said to be hidden, Tiger Mountain. Old masters who perfected their martial arts are said to meet at the top of the mountain. With a Shambhala key, you can gain the blessing of an elder master, which will surely help you. A divine light is emanating from the top, a sign that the key is still there. Also, this mountain has a face, and it kind of looks like a monkey more than a tiger, I think. This is going to be tough. The mountain is an arduous climb. You could have someone lead the climb, or maybe it's better to let someone find a hidden route. Let's have a look. The ultimate climb. Only the best will make it. So we actually have a 63% chance to make the climb before using a tool, and we would definitely use a tool. What about the other way? 59% chance. Oh wow, and failure there is a real bummer. Yeah, we're going to try the other way. Prepare for the climb. We only have one tool. But there are three Shambhala keys to try to get. I think we're going to take the raw 63% chance. Come on, Pedrino, don't fail us now. Do it, buddy. Do it. Do it. Oh, you're a hero. Everybody's hero. Look how happy we all are. Philippe has totally forgotten whatever he was so mad at you about earlier. And what a climb it is. It takes a great deal of time, but the crew climbs like heroes under the expert guidance of Pedrino. Soon you will see what is at the top. A martial arts monastery, like in every good kung fu movie. In the middle of the monastery, you see what you're looking for, the key. You also see a familiar figure chanting his own name and practicing swings. It's Rivalu's fighter, Tommy Gunn. Also, that's the name of a porn star. I feel like they could have done a tiny bit of research, maybe avoided that little collision. He's looking a bit weird because of the Shangri-La's dream-shaping properties. He's yelling at his goons. This is it, guys! We're the champions! Our failure as the gun baseball team will be forgotten. With this key, we'll finally be appreciated by the world. And that's when they notice you. Tommy turns to you. Ah, it's you. Well, I know what you're after, but the Shamblabla key is mine. If I take it, everyone will finally appreciate me, and maybe I can be part of a baseball team again. We'll duel for this to see who the real champion is. He's not letting us take it. Well, we're just going to take it. I'm not afraid of a baseball player. Look at his stupid tiny hat. Ah, he's considered a boss, so we get mad campaign tokens if we beat him up. Okay, well, what do we got here? We got some dudes in baseball uniforms supporting Tommy with their big swings. Seriously, maybe they do know that it's the name of a porn star. His swings do bonus damage to enraged opponents, or maybe this is just talking about the fact that enraged opponents take more damage from physical attacks due to the armor debuff. 80 spirit, 25 armor, weak to enrage, and gun cheerleaders. They got some pretty cool, mobster cheerleader outfits on. That's cool. One of Tommy's fantasies brought to life by the powers of Shangri-La. Makes friends confident, throws maddening insults, and has no particular weaknesses and 70 speech defense. Well. Defeat the boss. This doesn't look that bad. Oh, there's another guy down here. I'm pretty sure that the boss encounters in Shangri-La don't have infinite backup, so I think we actually can just tear through all of his cronies and then fight him 1-on-3. And that sounds like the definition of fairness to me. So we're going to move here, we're going to enrage her. No, we're not. Does she have grit? Nope, that was just a hard miss. Well, you have the highest attack stat, so get in there. Alright, good. That removes one source of buffs. Then Philippe can take this guy on. If we attack him, we're going to lose our grit bonus. I definitely don't want to do this and make him confident. So, I guess we'll just try to make him sad. Him being sad doesn't really do anything for us, but spirit damage is spirit damage. Yeah, if we can thin out this crowd of goons before Tommy actually reaches us, it's going to make the encounter a lot easier. And I believe in our ability. to thin out a bunch of goons. Alright, lucky miss. Philippe is going to get attacked twice, I think. And then the guy in the bottom left might be able to reach Pedrino, or he might not. Wow. We're getting really lucky here. This space is adjacent to three of them. How much damage does party time do to these guys? Oh, basically nothing. They're half resistant to it. Philippe might be able to finish him off. Come on, get there. Ah, not quite. So these guys are weak to enrage. Sadly the enrage will not down him. Here's my thinking. I really want to get rid of this guy. Pedrino's the only one who can reach him. If Pedrino ran around here, he could use enrage or party time to hit that guy. That means Bia doesn't get to contribute meaningfully this turn. Alright, here's what we're going to do. We're going to terrify this guy, and then we're just going to try to enrage him. And if it works... Yes! Alright, that'll get us 2 points of... 2 points of deviousness, put us back into crit bonus territory. And it does remove... Ooh! Uh-oh. They changed tactics. Alright, we're still getting lucky with the grit we have left over. I'm not excited about everybody ending up in enraged territory. That'll mean when we switch back to aggressive, and that is definitely what's going to happen in a minute here. We're going to take a ton of extra damage. That's a real disappointment. Alright. Let's just do our best to keep tearing through these guys. I'm going to have Philippe use his attack so that the... Oh, actually, I should have done it the other way around. The reason I did that was so that I would have Terrify available, but given that they've all switched over to speech, maybe I should have done it the other way around so that Sadden would still be available from Philippe. Also, it's possible that I should have used Tranquility to keep Pedrino up, because he might go down now. And that wouldn't be the end of the world, but it would be disappointing. Alright, that's lucky. This guy's not going for Pedrino either. Alright, it looks like we're just going to get a super, super good Tranquility off this turn. Oh. Okay. The fact that Pedrino's the stopwatch that we equipped on him, or the pocket watch rather, gives resistance to enraged attacks, I believe. And that's the only reason that he's still alive. Well, alive, you know what I mean. So if we do this, it'll knock us over into aggressive. But using her double slash on him is the only way to bring him down in one attack. Being aggressive when they're tense, or being aggressive when they're devious, gives us minus 30 speech resist. That doesn't sound great. Yeah, she can't get him in one go with any of her other abilities, though. Alright, we're gonna do it. We're just gonna keep thinning the herd as quickly as possible. Yep, that happened. And we are going to finish this guy off. Alright, two more down. So what do we got left? Tommy and two batters and... Okay, beautiful. That's excellent. So Tommy and two batters and one cheerleader. The cheerleader should go down pretty quickly. They have poor armor. the batters can be enraged. And then we just gotta deal with Tommy. Right, we definitely don't want him having confidence like that. Is this space adjacent to Tommy's space? It's hard to tell. I don't think it is. Alright, we're gonna go here. Yeah, if I did party time here, I wouldn't hit Tommy. My thinking there was just that I want Tommy to have a different attribute than confident. But that's really unfortunate. That's a bad time for a miss. Yeah, your sadness. Tommy is actually weak to sadness. And to being impressed. Alright, let's try to impress Tommy. To get him off of confident. Because I don't really want him doing 25% extra damage. We've still got like a million turns until Tranquility is back available. And we gotta get rid of these guys. This'll do a reasonable amount of damage. If we do that again next turn, he'll die. And we should be able to take care of the cheerleader next turn as well. That's interesting. Tommy healed everybody. Nobody was injured, so it didn't do anything, but... Oh, I might be ganging up on Philippe very successfully here. Okay, he lives. Alright. So I think if we stay aggressive, they'll stay aggressive, and I really would prefer that. Yeah, we're not able to get her off of, Well, maybe we'll get lucky. Like I said, there's some variance in the attack damage, but it seems like the value of the bar is the minimum damage of the attack rather than the average. So you can sometimes get it to vary upward quite a bit, but I don't think I've ever seen it vary downward. Which I like a lot. I think that that's a good way of doing it. Okay, that's lucky. Come on, Petrino. Dodges. Yeah. Okay, I'm happy about that. You still need one more turn on Tranquility. We're all so low. I'm actually starting to get a little bit nervous. This would hit everybody. It'll get them all off confident. It'll get her down. Yeah, this is the play. Alright. Okay, it's 53 spirit. I'm gonna heal her just because I'm really nervous about everybody getting KO'd at the same time. That would be a really embarrassing way to lose all of a sudden, you know? Alright. Come on. Yeah, she got him. Good, good, good. Alright. The 1-on-3. I am confident that we can get this. Although, Pedrino's enraged for some reason. Because he took a bad taunt recently. Right, it's definitely time for Tranquility. Now we have to start working on getting his attitude down. This seems to be the most damaging thing I can do. Okay. I was a little bit concerned that he was going to stop in the regen zone. Wow, he really does a lot of damage. That's unfortunate. I'm not going to apply a lot of strategy here. We're really just going to try to wear this guy down. I would get more damage out of Impress, but first of all, she just has tried to impress, so it's not even guaranteed to hit. What was that? He just didn't do anything. That was strange. Alright, let's just keep trying to drop his attitude. Honestly, he may go down before we manage to get him into a place where he could become enraged. Never mind. He's now in a place where he can become enraged. I don't want to jinx anything, but I dare say we've got this. Disarming smile. Guaranteed to hit, guaranteed to push the enrage, and then Bia finishes him off. If I had realized that I was going to get so many campaign tokens for beating the mini-bosses, I might have chosen to double our renown contribution from status. That seems like a pretty big mistake caused by ignorance there. Oh, I didn't read that text box. Tommy was sad because we beat him up. Now he's out of the way. Now you can pick up what you've been looking for. The Shambhala Key of Strength is yours, and a great find it is. Alright, 150 renown, no additional effects except for the fact that we have that thing that gives us a treasure hunt token every time we find a treasure. With that, your adventure on the peaks of Tiger Mountain has concluded. Your adventure has concluded. With the Shambhala Key of Strength in your backpack, Bia is more certain of finding the Sintamani. Yeah, I'm feeling pretty good about it. So the other two keys... what's going to be the best way to get over there? Probably this, because it leads right to one of them. Here we go. This area seems to be the site of an ancient monastery. You might want to study the place. Yeah, we might. I'm feeling pretty good on supplies. Oh, sorry, hit the mic stand with my knee there. I'm feeling pretty good on supplies. Yeah, we'll take the risk. It's a lot of tokens. Oh, did we get it? No, not quite. The crew fails to find anything and burns extra supplies in the effort. Yeah, that's my bad. That's my bad leadership. Let's get to the key. You arrive at the infamous Cave of the Crane. The cave has some mysterious rooms where one's intelligence is tested by a mysterious entity. If you do it correctly, you will find the Shambhala Key of Mind. Bia sure wants it to gain a better chance of getting the Sintamani. Yeah, I want it too. Let's get it. You enter the cave and the doors shut down behind you. The crew walks on in the cold mist until you enter a massive closed gate. You hear a clunky, mysterious voice. What are the most important elements for life? I don't know. Give us the key. Wrong! You get one more chance to answer the remaining 100 questions correctly. Who wrote The Art of War? Oh boy, it seems you're stuck answering all these questions. Who will give the final answers? Well, it's going to be Bia, and we're going to use our key, tool here. It would be really cool if we could succeed at this. Oh, okay. Whew. It takes you about an hour, but Bia managed to find all the correct answers to the 100 questions. The voice is impressed. Very well. You are a know-it-all. You may proceed. Hey, we got a collect token. There it is, the Shambhala Key of Mind you've been looking for. It sits waiting for you to take it. So, you only fight one of Rivalu's three henchmen. Whichever key you get to first is guarded by the henchman that it's most appropriate to. So if we'd gotten to the Cave of the Crane before the monastery, then we would have had to deal with Cassandra Shafiq here in front of the Shambhala Key. I'm glad that they were laid out the way they were, because I think that Tiger Mountain is the easiest of the encounters. That's it. The key is in your possession, improving your chances of getting the Sintamani. You leave the Cave of the Crane and its questions behind to continue your grand adventure. It is kind of grand, right? Alright, extra supplies, that would be cool. A group of Revelous henchmen is running around frantically. We saw a Yeti! You must hear me out! A Yeti? Really? Tell me more! Yes, we wrote down some useful notes! We should find him in the honor of Rivalu! Well, that's not gonna happen. You need to convince them to just give you the information they have. I'm tactically prepared to convince people to give me information. I've really run that scenario over in my head a bunch of times. So what do we got here? This doesn't look too bad. So the elite henchmen are weak to being excited. The others are weak to being encouraged. And they all have... Okay, the elite henchmen don't even have any armor on. So that's my in. They're resistant to sadness. Right, we're going to do this to make our party attitude friendly. Get a little speech defense. Sadly, it's looking like we're not going to be able to one-shot, or to two-shot this guy. Could Bia do it with violence? She could. I don't think it's a good idea to go that way with it, though. Not yet. And her fumble means that we won't be able to defeat this guy at all this turn. Let's try this. We'll try to enrage him. So we're definitely taking 3 attacks. This guy can definitely reach us. Yeah. But it shouldn't be more than that, at least. Alright, and that made them go pleasant, which means that we can backstab them, which I'm very excited about. What a jerk! Dare tip his hat to me. Okay, that's a good miss. The time has come for betrayal. Sweet, sweet victory. Take advantage of our speech defense here. Honestly, Pedrino can beat this guy, and we're not going to get 2 kills even if we use both of their turns, so... I'm going to take this opportunity to drop the heal so that we can get it on cooldown and get it back to being available as quickly as possible. Wow, that attack has some serious range. That deals a lot of damage, too. Damn. Alright, I like the fact that they want to spread their damage out. That's very pleasant for me. These guys are weak to excitement. Do I want to run Pedrino over there? It seems dangerous, but... Yeah, we'll go ahead and... I'm not afraid of exciting them, given that the combat has turned violent. Or that the encounter, I should say, given that the encounter has turned to combat. That'll drop her. That's good for us. Only one person with a gun. We'll fall in over here. We'll protect Philippe's backside. I think we're basically... There's no way not to lose Pedrino. Or at least there's no way to guarantee that we won't lose Pedrino. So we just kind of have to ignore him. But if the enemies all choose to attack healthier, better armored targets, I'm not going to complain. Alright. That went, I think, about as well as it possibly could have gone for us. So we'll drop him. She needs to go next. Sadly, I don't think we really have the tools to make that happen. Oh, sure we do. Because she takes so much damage from getting excited. And now Philippe can potentially finish it. Alright, he got there. Okay. So we actually haven't lost any resolve yet, and there's only two enemies left, so we probably won't lose more than one resolve on this encounter. Oh wow. Lucky us. Enrage this guy to drop his armor, then give him the sword, obviously. At this point, our routine is probably second nature to you. Even though my attack would be nice, it'll certainly deal more damage than this. I'm not going to use attack because I want to keep my grit bonus through the final enemy turn. Or what I am presumptively assuming is the final enemy turn, I guess. Get this guy enraged, and then I think Philippe should be able to finish him off. Yep. Alright, these guys will give us information on the Yeti. I'd take a Yeti, I'll fight a Yeti. I'm not afraid of a Yeti. With the henchmen knocked out, you can take their notes on the Yeti and some of their supplies, too. Ooh, 4 study, 2 supplies. Okay. I want to explore a little bit because there is one more treasure site. That's always in the... That's always in the Shangri-La area. Actually, it looks like going here is going to reveal the most nodes to us. So let's just go ahead and get the key. You arrive at the Temple of Yabium, the symbol of love. Your deepest desires can come to life here. If Bia is correct, one of the Shambhala keys must be somewhere in this temple. You have to be careful, for the trap of seduction is said to be laid out here. You enter the temple and, goodness gracious, it's crawling with beautiful and charming people. They welcome the crew with undeniable warmth. Welcome, beautiful, intelligent, sweet people. Please join us and allow us to adore you. You must get across the room to continue, but this offer is tempting. Well, somebody's got to be able to get through. The crew moves forward while politely thanking all the people, but the crew's determination is faltering. This isn't going well. There's a gong on the other side of the room. Striking it is said to stop this beguiling madness. Man, there's an awful lot of, like, really specific information about this temple that is just is said. All hope rests on one person to win the Battle of Charms or Iron Will. They were pretty charming. Let's do the Battle of Charms. You can't be impressed if you're the most impressive one around. You can try to cross the room using charm. Which crew member is going to fight beauty with beauty? Well, actually, we're not very good at this. How about the other thing? A challenge of will. Someone has to make a final attempt to break through this pit of seduction on pure wit and will. We get +35% from the fact that Bia is dead serious about everything all the time, and then also she's a quick thinker. Well, let's go for it. 86% is pretty high, but it's not 100. Okay. Good. All three of the Shambhala keys. I feel pretty good about that. Bia has wills of steel. Wills of steel. and the beautiful people cannot keep Bia from reaching the other side of the room where Bia hits the gong. The beautiful people disappear like illusions, which makes Philippe kind of sad. The crew can now continue. You get a collect token and the Shambhala Key of the Heart. This will give you the blessings of the Shangri-La Elders and surely an edge over Rivaloo. I still feel like I must not be saying that right. And so the exploration of the Yabyum Temple comes to its conclusion. You are one step closer to getting the Sintamani and beating Rivaloo to becoming the best explorer in the world. So we have four... It's going to take basically all of our stuff just to... It's going to take all of our supplies to get back to... Okay. If we go this way, we'll run out of supplies right here and take a penalty. If we go through this encounter zone, we'll have one supply left here and we won't have to take a penalty. But we could potentially lose, resolve here, which would be bad. What's that? A group of small demons are gathered around a demon leader. The one on Mount Kailash isn't looking! We will infest the mountains once again! Defeating such a horde would be noteworthy. We must engage the leader and his demons. We need to warn the one on Mount Kailash. You turn to head to Mount Kailash, but the demons spot you. Travelers to pester! This is probably supposed to be like a... Get them! Yeah, right, I'll fight some demons. We fought demons before. It worked out pretty well last time. Alright, if we defeat them friendly, they don't change their ways. If we defeat them deviously, they start bickering and disappear. And if we defeat them aggressively, glory awaits. And we get a lot of tokens from all of our various token triggers. So no blue demons. Four green demons and a red. Okay. Well, let's start friendly. Try to get an impress off on one of these guys. No such luck. They don't have any grit, she just whiffed, because she's bad. Alright, let's block him in. Man, we really do not have a lot of options. Alright, we're going to hit this guy with the excitement and then hit him with the confidence so that he doesn't end the turn excited. And we're going to hope that our display of friendliness causes them to switch over to a friendly mood as well so that we can backstab the crap out of them. If we don't get that going, I don't know how we're going to win this. Also, it's a little bit frustrating that the AI's moods work completely, or the AI's attitudes rather, work completely differently than ours. We have to take actions to redistribute points to get our attitudes to the right place. The AI literally just decides what attitude they want to have at the beginning of the turn. There's nothing more complicated than that to it. This is really unfortunate. How much damage? Really not very much damage from party time. Even boosted by hitting three at the same time, I don't know if it's going to be enough. But I also don't think we really have any other choice. So, party time. Maybe we'll get lucky and it'll drop this guy. Nope. And now we're doomed. These guys have comparatively little armor, so we're going to do an unnoticed strike. I bet he noticed. Alright, this coming turn... Oh, alright, great. I was going to say, this coming turn, I think, is the turn that we have to turn on them whether we're ready to or not. Actually, it might already be too late. We're going to lose a ton of resolve here. Man, are we going to get all the way through the game to the very end and then lose in Shangri-La? I think that might be what's happening here. Yeah, we lose. Crap. Because Bia can run, but she can't get far enough. She can't get close to the others to revive them because the demons have formed a wall. Well, this is anticlimactic. We acquired all of the Shambhala keys. Yeah, and then he jumps in front. Crap. He has 20 armor and 95. Maybe this will drop him? I mean, we lose if it doesn't, so let's go for it. Yeah, the second strike does a lot less, does only about half damage. Alright, speech defense up. She does have 40 grit. She just has to not take any spirit damage at all from anything, ever. Okay, that's a pretty good start. This is tough, though. Because if we run away, these demons are just going to funnel into this bottleneck. If we fight this guy, the demons will come through here and still hit us. If we move to here, I think this demon will still be able to attack us as well. This is bad. Alright, if I move to here and I beat this guy with this, I think I'll only take one attack this turn doing it this way, because I don't think these guys can quite... Oh no, he totally can. Well, never mind. Oh, and there goes my speech defense. We got so close to the end. Tyrant Tycoon Bia Hackathon was attacked and traumatized in the Himalayan peaks by a bunch of sadistic demons. And let's not even talk about what happened after that. Well, expedition failed. To become a great expedition leader, play the game a whole lot better than you did right there. The funny thing is that was just one little thing went wrong in that battle, and it cascaded into complete unrecoverability. That's very disappointing. Well, that's it for this expedition. Come back next time when we try again with a different team, a different strategy, and hopefully a different result.